If you're a longtime fan of this channel, you know I've been making camo guides since Black Ops 2. And in fact, the first guide was for the assault shield. And that thing only took a few hours to get gold. We thought it was hard back then. Well, get ready, because the Modern Warfare Riot Shield is by far the hardest, most tedious weapon to get gold to date. And in its current form, you're looking at 15 plus hours of dedicated shield gameplay. Yeah, it's terrible. Unlike today's sponsor, Ting, it's the pay-as-you-go mobile service I've been using since 2014. Visit mikey.ting.com for $25 in free credit, link down below. So let's talk about the challenges. First up is spray paint, get 200 kills. And this is a passive challenge. It's gonna happen no matter what. Here is my stats after getting gold on the Riot Shield: 481 kills, 556 deaths, a 0.8 KDR, zero headshots, and a 2.0 accuracy. How does that work? So don't worry, you're gonna get more than 200 kills. So the first challenge is Woodland, get 50 kills while injured. Class setup for all these challenges is obviously the Riot Shield. Secondary, I highly recommend picking up a good handgun, either the 357 or the 1911, really any handgun, work on that. And as an added bonus, you might end up getting it gold along the way. And that's another thing, don't feel like you only have to use the shield. Use that pistol for distant kills or just to get your first perk. So speaking of perks, we're not running streaks. Okay, no streaks. The reality is you're not going to be getting a VTOL, chopper gunner, etc. Even a UAV is going to be pretty rare with the Riot Shield. So instead, get yourself some more perks, hover over your perks, and just hit activate specialists. And this is a setup I pretty much ran 99% of the time. EOD to take damage from the claymores, proximity mines, etc. You will crash into them. People will throw grenades at you when they see you. And the second perk, Hardline. Hardline is going to make it so one kill and you got ghost, three kills you get restock, five kills double time, or whatever perks that you want. But I do highly recommend using ghost as the first perk you unlock. And then this game's a version of Tac Mask, battle hardened. You know how it is when you see someone with the shield, dude, they're throwing stuns and mollies and all kinds of stuff at them. So you got to have those types of perks to protect you. So the restock can become pretty useful if you live that long, so you can get more stuns to throw stuns at people, slow them down, hit them with the melee. And then you got the double time, and that's going to help out a little bit later. I'll go over that. Okay, so for the lethals, at least for this challenge, the lethal is going to be a thermite, and then the tactical overall for all the challenges, stun is good, just again to slow people down, run up to them and bash them with the shield. So for a lot of the previous challenges, you already know Hardcore Headquarters, it's really good. It's fast paced, very few hit markers, and that's still the case for the Riot Shield. The Riot Shield in Hardcore is one hit. Hardcore is great mode, kill confirmed, by far the best mode. I did all the research for you guys. You need to find the hot spot on each map. Okay, so here's the best maps, at least so far in the first month that the game is out. Shoot House in that office where you already know people love camping up there. You're gonna have to camp up there. Office. San Petro, it's either of the middle buildings, the staircases, the bar downstairs. Basically the two buildings that people like to run to off of spawn. And again, this is for kill confirmed. It doesn't really work for any other mode. The best map, hands down, where I got most of my kills, Ramaza. Middle of the map, either the top section or all those rooms in the bottom. And Gunrunner. Gunrunner is great, either the pipes room or the bathroom. And you kind of see a theme here. It's really close quarters. That's where the shield really shines. You want to box in people. Don't give them room to run. Really tight spaces. So in the future, when we get more maps, you're going to want to find hotspots, close quarters, very close quarters. The smaller, the better. And kill confirmed. That way there isn't an objective you have to run to, and you're not really holding back your team. You know, you're sort of doing your own thing. And the maps to skip, the cave map, skip that. Picadillo, always skip Picadilly. And raid, skip that one, it's just too big. All right, so we're gonna kick it off on Shoot House. And here's the thermite, this guy happened to be here, but basically here's the strategy to get the kills while injured. And you wanna get your screen to where it's almost a black screen, but you wanna take so much damage to where you get the black halo around your screen. You can tap the thermite, but that won't register as kills while injured. You can use stun, but that didn't seem to work all the time. So thermite, absolutely consistent. I was able to get up to 13 kills while injured in one game. Now it depends on the map, of course, but up in the office room, I guess, limiting the movement, really. You want to limit your movement, their movement, and people love coming up to the office regardless. And if you're up here, and yeah, kind of blew myself up. If you're up here, people are going to want to keep coming up there to get revenge on you. And basically, if you're able to hear people, there is different sounds. So the wood out in the main room sounds definitely different than the footsteps of someone coming up at the stairs. Coming up the stairs definitely has a different tone. Speaking of which, when you hear people, I want you to notice the movement. When someone is close by, you need to stand up, don't crouch, stand up and get in their face and press them and push forward. So if you're constantly pressing forward, standing up, you know, I would say like if you're in the same room, you know, very close to them, that's gonna make it very hard for them to shoot you in the feet. Now, if they get distance on you, then you're gonna have to crouch. Honestly, you're just gonna learn it the hard way. And the other number one advice is never ever sprint at someone with your shield. You can sprint to catch up to them, but never sprint at someone because your shield pretty much goes completely down. And even if it looks like you pulled it back up, from third person, from their point of view and everyone else's point of view, your shield is half down. So you should never sprint at someone. The only time you need to sprint is maybe if they have their back towards you or if you're trying to get from point A to point B. Other than that, never sprint, just, you know, walk, stand up, move forward. Once you get that down, your KD is going to go up. And by up, I mean, hey, maybe if you're lucky, you'll get a 1 KD. So here's the second clip. And yeah, here's the pipes room. Of course, immediately throw down the thermite, get that. I guess it's not a black screen. It's just like a smoky screen. You want to get the smoky screen. That way, you know, you took enough damage and don't heal yourself with a stem shot or any of that. But I like the pipe room and the bathroom on this map because it's very close quarters, and always use the doors. It doesn't matter what map it is, use the doors. You can use them as sound cues. People love bursting right on through. So if you have a headset, it's gonna help you a lot. And you know, I'd alternate between the pipes room and the bathroom. It depends on the enemy's spawn. If they're spawning in the back, pipe room is better. If they're spawning towards a big warehouse, bathroom is better. But this is an ongoing theme on all the maps. You just gotta find that hot spot, and you guys will know by playing the game. You're gonna know where people always congregate in rooms that are tight, small, and even better if they have doors. The bathroom has a lot of good sound cues. Okay, there's doors on each side, and if someone tries coming in through the bottom, they're gonna make a lot of splashing noises. It's really, really loud, those footsteps down at the bottom. And if you don't want to shut the door, you can always hide behind a door. And that, again, tight spaces, close quarters is where the riot shield is going to shine. You're just going to have to, you will learn by trial and error. So, you know, I could tell you all the tips you want that you're going to learn once you're in there. Because once I had that down, man, I just played so much better. Okay, digital is get 50 kills from behind. That is probably going to be passive. I'm going to say that's as passive as you can get. With the ghost perk, you know, you're going to sneak up on people. And speaking of sneaking up on people, we have dragon. Get 50 kills with dead silence. I'm not going to say that's passive, but what you want to do is get into the habit of popping the dead silence when you hear footsteps, if you're trying to sneak up on someone. And another kind of a weird thing with this challenge is there is a big grace period of kills counting once the deady wears off, the dead silence. And what I found was even after dead silence wore off, there'd be like maybe 5 seconds I could still get some melee kills, and that counted. So this was super duper easy. You don't even have to try for it. But dead silence is useful anyways, and you should be using it when you know people are nearby. So then we got splinter, 50 kills while crouching. And this was actually kind of difficult, but all you really want to do is maybe you want to rearrange your perks so that double time has a higher priority. So you can have double time on by default, or maybe have double time one of the first perks that you unlock. Reason being, the tactical sprint gets doubled, so that's really good. but it increases your crouch movement by 30%. But really, if you're sneaking up on someone, just remember to crouch before you melee them. And you know, it's gonna get hard. It's a little bit harder at first because you don't naturally want to crouch before you melee someone. It just takes a couple, you know, maybe 10-15 kills, and then you're used to it. Just remember, crouch before killing someone. So then there's Topograph. Kill two enemies without dying 25 times. You cannot use your pistol and then get a kill. It has to be two shield kills in that life. So you can get a melee kill and then a couple pistol kills and then a shield kill. As long as it is two shield kills in that life, you're good. Do that 25 times. So then it's Tiger, 25 kills while the enemy is near smoke. So here's a few weird things about this one. Gas grenades count. Yes, they do. I don't recommend using them. I prefer using the smoke grenade since it has a bigger radius. But yes, gas grenades count. Friendly and enemy smoke and gas grenades count. And this one has a big grace period, bigger than the Dead Silence perk. And I swear I got kills long after the smoke cleared and it still counted. So there's no real tips here other than toss the smoke in your chosen high traffic area and just continue playing in that area. It is really big and you're gonna get a lot of kills long after you throw the smoke and they're still gonna count. So it's kind of weird, but hey, I appreciate it. Then it's Stripes, get 10 buzz kills, passive. That's gonna happen on its own. And then there's Reptile, execute 25 finishing moves. Another weird one. So every finisher seems to count as three finishers. Yeah, hey, again, I appreciate it. And then there's this really weird glitch that kind of works sometimes. Your pistol finisher will count as not only as a riot shield finisher, but also that counts as three. So I'm not sure how long this is going to be a thing, but just to be safe, swap to your shield before performing the finisher. And with this class, with your playstyle, you're going to catch a lot of people off guard. So it's not really something you have to really focus on. Just remember to hold down the melee button before you bash them, and it should trigger the finisher as long as you're kind of sort of behind them. Okay, so it's kind of bugged, but it's bugged in the good way. Three finishers for one, hey, I'll take it. And then finally is Skulls. Kill three enemies without dying. So actually, I was done with all the previous challenges, so I had to keep getting kills to rank up the shield before this challenge unlocked. So that's what I'm saying. Don't even worry about hitting 200 kills. You're gonna hit more than that, and you're probably gonna need to keep going in order to get Skulls. So just like the two kills in one life, now it's three kills in one life. Thankfully, it's only 25 times. And really, the big thing is all the previous tips, but pay attention to the footsteps. The footsteps sounds in office. The stuns are going to help you out a lot. If you hear people inside of a room, you can pre-stun it. But by the time you get to Skulls, you will have the gameplay down, and it's going to be relatively easier. And, you know, hey, go back and forth between Hardcore Headquarters. Try that. That worked out a couple times. And go to Kill Confirmed. But personally for me, Kill Confirmed, Hardcore Kill Confirmed, I just got so many more kills, and at one point I had 13 melee kills in one game, so it can work. So the riot shield, it really wasn't that hard to get kills. You know, once I had the playstyle down, stand up if they're up close, push them, rush, and if they're far, crouch. It's just the sheer number is just what is not fun about this. And as I said, it took me close to 15 hours alone, probably the longest of any weapon in all the series. So please, hey, why not rate the video? And the other thing is I would save this weapon for the very, very end, because who knows, they may lower the requirements. I mean, they already changed it used to be 25 double kills. They changed that to two kills in one life. So, you know, if they change that right now, you know, who knows? Maybe in a month, a couple months from now, they'll lower the requirements. The thing is, they're not getting a lot of complaints because the game is still new and a lot of people aren't focusing on that. But as people get through their assault rifles and snipers and secondaries, and then they have to do the melee, they're definitely going to get a lot of tweets and stuff like that. So hey, why not save it for the very, very end, unless you really want to flex on people. Ting is a mobile service I personally have been using since 2014. there are no contracts, and you only pay for what you actually use. So the average Ting bill is just $23 for a single device, although personally, my bill never seems to crack 20 bucks, so it's perfect if you're someone like me who uses Wi-Fi for your data. Head to their site, play with the bill estimator, and see how much you would save. And if you go to mikey.ting.com, you get $25 in free credit. You can use that in their online store, or you can just save it and pay your bill with it. Mikey.ting.com, link to that down below. With that out of the way, what weapon should we get gold next? Leave a comment below what we should work on. So on the left side there, we have the full playlist of all the gold camo guides, and on the right, a brand new video.